guys, this is Andrew. This is Moinsu Day. Hey, for this video, we are going to be doing another battleship test here. So, here we are. The next test, the Henri the Fourth AP shell test against all six current tier 10 battleships. Yep. All thanks to this to our newcomer, the Kremlin, from Soviet Russia. All right. So, guys. Alright, so the rules for this test are pretty simple. You know, I shoot. You know, I take my Henri the Fourth. You know, shoot each battleship from a broadside and see how many hits they can, how many salvos they can survive. Alright, here. So, just gotta grab my scoreboard out here quickly. The rules for this will be are simple. Whoever survives, whichever battleship survives, has the most hits, it is the most durable. Will be the wins the competition here. So, competition, I mean, the point of this test is really to try and make it accurate to what, you know, normal scenarios to maybe areas, because I try and make my test as accurate as possible, you know, for any viewers who are less experienced. So, for the first up here, we're gonna start with the curve first here, which in the previous two tests, which actually lasted the longest in my Des Moines test here and had the test here. So heads up to that. So. Hats off to the curve first here. Okay, what else? Anyway, almost there. Alright, anyway. Enough talk! Let's get right into this. In 3, 2, 1. Let's see what these shells do here. Ouch! Ouch indeed. Only 7 hits. That's impressive. Alright, that's 1. 2. Okay, 3. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. A little too high on that one. Eleven. And right, this should be the finisher here. And okay, 12. Okay, I'll just go 12 for that. Because now the thing's saturated. So, not that bad. Not that bad here. Like, I'm just gonna leave that thing alive. No, I'm kidding. Let's just kill it off for the fun of it. So that's the cure first. Next up, we have the Republic here. In 3, 2, 1. One. Two. Three. Four. Six. Okay, should I hit right below the... Okay, I'm gonna try to hit right below the R line for this one. That's seven. Eight. Nine. I think that was a terrible one. Okay, that was a terrible one. Okay, that was a pretty terrible one. Ten. Do it. Alright, so that was 10 hits for the Republic here. The Curvers is still in the lead. Alright. Next up we have, of course, the Yamato. Of course we have the Yamato. Oh boy, this is gonna be fun. Oh boy, I can actually remember in the last time we tested an Henri the Fourth on this thing, it really killed it off in two salvos. Oh, it's because I was actually just... See, I think I might have hit the right spot. Okay, anyway, enough talking about that situation. Let's go right into it. One. Oh, ouch, it's gonna hurt. Two. Ow. Three. Oh yeah, that's where you're supposed to hit it. Alright. I mean, Okay, I'm just gonna say, three for that. I'm just gonna say, three for the, Yamato. I mean, yes, I counted a little more than that, but then again, I was, hitting over here, which is not the spot where you want to hit the Yamato, this is where you want to hit, in the middle. So yep, same thing as the previous test. Gets really Trump, just gets wrecked, just got wrecked. I'm sorry, Yamato fans, but yep, be careful against Henri the Fourth here. There's a reason I didn't mash the torpedo test and AP shell test into one. Specifically for the Yamato. And in the torpedo test, we will actually finish off each ship with armor-piercing shells. Sing shells. So, anyway, next up we have the Montana. And sorry for anyone who lives in the state of Montana. I'm sorry, you're a fan of this battleship. I'm sorry, all Americans. I mean, it's because I'm an American too, as you can tell. Anyway.
Enough talk!
In 3, 2, 1. Oh! Oh, that's. Oh, that's got hurt. Oh! Okay, that's one. Two. Oh. Oh. I mean, it's doing at least better than the Yamato. I mean, it's doing much better than the Yamato, though. I mean, when I hit the Yamato in mid-step section, it did twice that damage. Okay, in the second step. Okay, that's three. Okay, I think I've over-damaged the, damaged the system. Okay. E. Four. Five. Okay, I think if I strike it up in the upper armor belt, it'll hurt even more. Six. Oh. Seven. I know that's really, I know it's a terrible seven. Okay, that's a proper seven. Eight. And. Alright, so that's it for the Montana. Okay. Boy, that thing got the crap kicked out of it. I mean, at least not as badly as the Yamato, though. That really got the crap kicked out of it. The Yamato seriously got the crap kicked out of itself. Alright, something tells me the Kremlin is not gonna last, gonna do very well. I know, well, because if you guys remember when I, overviewed this thing in the port, I mean, as you guys probably can tell, know already, this ship has a very high sail, which is above the waterline, just like with the Soviet cruisers, so... Oh, this thing's bound to be kicked pretty bad. Alright. Just need to align into a proper position here just to make sure I'm getting no ricochets. Alright, are we in a good one? Alright. We're about in that position. Okay, I think that's good enough. In 3, 2, 1. Ow! Oh, that's even more than the Montana. I even citadeled it. Killed it as well. That's one. Two. Oh! That hurt just as much as the Yamato. Oh! I did not expect that. Yeah, I knew this. No, I'm kidding. I knew this was that having I said I was gonna kick the was gonna man, this thing was gonna have the crap kicked out of it. Okay, it's three. And finally, four. Kremlin really got the crap kicked out of it. I mean, at least not as bad as the Yamato in Montana, though. At least not as bad as the Yamato, though. I don't know, that really got the crap kicked out of it. That really got the crap. Even though I had hit it a little too far off, it still got kicked really bad. Well, it proves all. Well. Oh, thing's gonna break. Oh, broke. Oh. Yep, it broke. This is usually the engine moves on this one. And I've got one more repair party. Excuse me, no. Reload boost ready. So. Okay. Okay, should be coming closer. Okay, Conqueror's probably not going to do very well. Conqueror's probably not going to do very well against me, too. I mean, the Republic and the Kerfers held up pretty well against me, but the Montana, got a little crap kicked out of it, but, I mean, Yamato and the Kremlin, though, they really got the crap kicked out of themselves. Oh, it's here. Right? Let's see what my Henri can do here in 3, 2, 1. One. Okay, it's probably gonna, like, get kicked just as much as the, Montana. Two. Three. Four. Already down to halfway, half of its HP. Five. Six. Okay, he's already beaten the Montana. Nine. And number 10. Oh, okay, you know what? Okay, you know what? Okay, that should have been 10. I'm just gonna write 10 for the Conqueror. Because I shot by one. Because you should have taken more damage than that. Alright, guys, so that's our Henri the Fourth armor piercing test. So, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. But anyway, before I end this video here, I'm just going to recap. So, Kremlin got killed in 4 hits. So, 4 hits. So the Kremlin got killed in 4 hits. Yamato, 3 hits. Kerfurst, 12 hits, which is the highest. So the Kerfurst, has already gained first place in my Des Moines burnout test and my Henri the Fourth AP test. So hats up to the Kerfurst again. Republic, one, and Conqueror, both 10 for them. Took 10 hits to kill them, and Montana, 8 hits to kill it. So guys, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, definitely press that like button and subscribe to this channel. And especially if this video was helpful for you guys for future Henri the Fourth players. And anyway. And if you're already subscribed to this channel, don't forget to turn on that notification bell so that way you'll be notified every time a new video like this is posted. And I'll see you guys next time for the torpedo test. Bye!